So change has been happening.
They're patrolling every neighborhood.
Trouble breathing. Some coca tea.
He's so happy to be in here.
Good morning, guys. It's Sunday, which means we're not allowed out of the house. So all of today we'll be stuck in this house, but that's okay because look at the weather right now. And we brought a friend in. He was cold outside, so we decided to give him a little food and water and a place to sleep for a little bit.
How you doing?
Happy and cozy.
He's so happy to be in here.
So lately we've been having a little bit of trouble breathing. I have more so than Lindsay, but both of us have a little bit. And we're thinking it's because of the elevation. You can have problems up here with the elevation, getting full breaths of air. And so we're having some coca tea. Lindsay got this yesterday, and I think it's been helping.
Coca extracts are used for stimulating stomach function, causing sedation, and treating asthma, colds, and other ailments. Coca tea is used for altitude sickness in the Peruvian Andes and elsewhere. So I think it helps increase the oxygen that your body's receiving. Thank goodness for coca tea.
So we had a little scare because I was thinking it could be coronavirus because we're starting to hear that one of the symptoms is shortness of breath. We're in one of the highest elevation cities that we know of, and people have troubles here, so we got a little bit of this coca tea and it saved my life. So we asked you guys what we should name our new dog here, and you didn't disappoint. So let's go over your names. Spud, like a potato. That was
we thought he looked kind of like a little potato, and Peru is known for their potatoes.
Cusco, Linder, which we think is a mixture of Lindsay and Alexander.
Clever.
Travel Barker. If it's a female, call her Mayu, which means river in Quechua. Virus.
Come here, virus.
We'll think about it. Cusco, Spike, Poncho, Gilbert. All you can do is consider naming the dog. Wake up, man. You failed to protect your woman all through this crisis, and now you let her out on her own with no man to protect her should she be attacked. That's not a name, but that was within the names list. Pedro. Cusco Bum. Perito. Machu Picchu. Dave. COVID-19.
These were very entertaining. It looks like if we were to tally the votes, Cusco would definitely take first place. But we decided to name him something a little different than what you guys suggested. Mr. Potato Head.
So I'm cooking tonight. I'm cooking Lindsay a surprise. Look at this. Look at that. So it's buttered and salted potatoes with tomatoes, avocado, crushed up little veggie chips, sprouts, little dried beef pieces, a couple different types of cheese. Let's see how it is.
I'm excited. Eating dinner on the couch and watching Netflix. Apparently he's really interested in watching Alex do the dishes.
You want to take over, buddy? You want to do the rest?
He's probably hoping he can lick the dirty dishes.
Good morning, guys. It's Monday, which means I'm allowed to go out and restock. We really need some food. Today, we have no avocado. I can't believe it. Lindsay just made me some cheesy eggs. And I'm answering some of your comments here. So leave a comment below if you want it answered in the next one. So today is my day to go out, and Lindsay isn't supposed to go out. But we were thinking, we're all out of food and we need to carry back a lot of stuff. So what if she does this?
Well, Alex had the brilliant idea that I could dress up like a guy and then I could go out with him today.
So this is Lindsay now, and now she's gonna change into this. How about that?
You like?
Damn, you would think that was me standing there. That's attractive.
Now I have to learn how to walk like the guy. Like, does this work?
Yeah.
This ain't obvious at all. Do you guys think I should try this? Do you think it's believable?
I thought that was me standing there for a second.
I'm a girl again.
So what do you guys think? Should Lindsay give it a try? Go out as a guy? As you can tell, we're a little bored.
Hi, little mister.
Oh. Come back with good groceries, por favor.
Hey, you wanna get groceries? You wanna get groceries? Come.
Alright, Lindsay gave me a long grocery list. So I'm going to our store. Got those. About a 10-minute walk. And gonna get the food that we need for the next few days. And here is Mr. Potato Head.
Come.
According to the new rule, only guys are allowed out today. And yeah, I've seen a lot of men out today. All the guys are out getting their supplies. Because yesterday was Sunday, nobody could go out. I think that's why today is such a popular day. Alright, you wait outside, Potato Head. Hey there, how you doing? Good boy. All right, tangerines, but on the deal. He's been waiting, looking at everybody. Hey, hey, how you doing? How you doing? Hey, he thought he lost me. Mr. Potato Head is really happy right now because he was waiting for me for 15 minutes and there were just so many people going by, all these guys in masks. I could see him just looking at all of them and trying to find me. And he didn't know which one was me. Finally, when he saw me, he was pretty excited, and now he's crying. Good boy. So change has been happening. Before, the cops, you'd only see them on the main streets. But now, they're patrolling all the little nooks and crannies of every neighborhood, making sure that only men are out, I think. So even right when we leave our door now, we're in this little neighborhood and I saw cops right away. Okay, so I got beans, less than a dollar for all these white beans. A bunch of mandarins, clementines, whatever these are. 6 palta and 5 granadilla.
I've been working from home, and I made you some tea, coca tea, to help with your respirations.
So the lady told me that if we got these beans, they have to be soaked overnight. So that's what we're about to try. All right, it's that time of day. We're gonna do your questions and comments now.
The first one we have is from Peter Kroll. He says, it seems that so many people are not aware about the seriousness of this crisis. This will not be over in May, and nothing will be lifted by then. It will stay with us for the next 4 to 6 months, at least.
So nobody really knows how long this thing is gonna go, and I know in our videos, sometimes we say that this might be lifted in another week.
and we just try to keep a positive outlook.
We want to be positive, but at the same time realistic. Like Alex says, no one really knows how long this is going to last, but yes, we're hopeful it will lift in a week when they say it's going to, but we're aware it could get extended and we are prepared for that.
So Manuel Alvarez says, in a way you should be glad you're stuck in Peru. They have the highest recovery rate for the COVID-19, 58% higher than Germany. And if you're stranded in your neighbor of Ecuador, you very well could be dead by now.
Yeah, it's crazy because we actually were almost going to go to Ecuador instead of Peru, but the flight just happened to be cheaper to go to Peru. In Ecuador right now, there's people that are dying and their family members are calling for help to get someone to come retrieve the body. Well, no one shows up for like 5 days and the body's just inside of their house rotting and decaying, so they have to put their loved one out on the street. So right now, Ecuador has dead bodies just laying on the streets. It's really not a good situation, so we're really thankful to be in Peru right now.
You reach your stand, you cry.
Go for a walk later. It's girls' day. You're a guy, but they'll let you out.
So Amaro Pargo says, wait, wait, you're a couple, right? How, when, where did you meet? I'll see some of your older vids. Lindsay?
So yes, we are a couple. We've been together for about 4 months. It all started when I was going to go travel on my own and I was looking up YouTube videos and came across his channel, which is Alexander Travelbum. That's his original channel. This is his new one. And then I messaged him and the messages just kept coming back and forth and we hit it off and we decided to meet up in Montana, which there's a video about that on his old channel. You should check it out. Mm-hmm. And we decided to travel together. This next one is from Susanna Lassus. She said, hope you guys are staying safe. Be careful. Do not go out when you're supposed to be in. They don't play over there. They will take you to jail. Be well.
So I wanted to highlight this comment because we get so many differing comments on all sides of the spectrum when it comes to this. First of all, we only go out to get food and water, so I think we are following the rules. We do go out every couple days, but you are allowed to do that. And in Cusco, there are actually quite a lot of people out walking around, so I don't think it's that bad here. It's not like it's just us. So some people say that if we go out at all, that we're not following the rules and that we can go to jail. We can go to jail for 5 to 10 years, something like that. And then some people say that we can do that all the time, that we're tourists, that it's totally fine and nothing's gonna happen to us. They're just trying to keep us safe. So I just wanted to highlight this comment because it's funny that we get such differing things from everybody on this channel.
Maybe it depends on the city you're in.
Yeah, we've heard that Lima is a lot worse. And so in Lima, Peru, maybe that is the case. Mm-hmm. Who knows?
All right, Rodolfo Benza said, I thought masks were mandatory. The dog didn't have one on.
We're sorry about that. We only bought 2 masks and we didn't give one to him. We're kind of selfish that way. But we will buy him one. We'll buy him the best quality mask and he'll be completely safe and he'll follow the rules from now on. We'll put him in timeout for a little bit.
Yeah, no rules really apply to Mr. Potato Head. He gets to go out with me on the girls' day and walk around. He doesn't have to wear a mask.
All right, this next one is from NinaVip68 or NinaVIP. Not sure. Aw, poor baby. Guys, please contact Cusco Protection de Animales on Facebook. It's a nonprofit animal shelter. They might be able to help him or find him a home.
Yeah, as we've been getting attached to this dog more and more, we've realized that obviously we can't hold on to him forever because we're going to continue traveling, but we want to make sure we can find him a really good home. So if any of you know anyone in Cusco, Peru, or in Peru in general that would want to take him in, let us know. But otherwise, this is a really good idea. We will get in touch with that Facebook group and see if there's anything they can do to help him.
Thank you guys for your comments. Keep them coming. We're going to answer comments in every video from now on. Now back to the dog.
Baby! Hi!
Oh,
so cute!
Hey!
Hey! Hi! Oh.
You came back!
Oh, hi!
Yeah!
I don't know where you went.
Do you want postcards from around the world? Right now I am writing and drawing on postcards to my subscribers. If you want to join my Patreon, click the link below. You'll be supporting the channel and you'll be getting something pretty cool with a drawing from me.
Hey, thanks for making it all the way through this video. If you want to watch more, click one of these videos. Subscribe, because I'm traveling all around the world and I'm sharing the whole thing with you. Thanks.